first what you want to do, there's a little slope right here that goes up. It's this little, this thing. It's a slope that goes all the way up. What you want to do is, there's a glitch in the game that allows you to jump up slopes, in a ridiculous way. For some reason, you can do it over here. It's pretty easy to see, I think. Run into it. Just run into it. Jump up. And you'll be fine. If you don't move, you'll get stuck in the whole area right there. So just sprint forward. And then immediately after sprinting forward, you want to jump. Since you're standing like right there, you want to jump facing that direction. So. There we go. So you want to basically hit that pillar going all the way up, and then what you'll do is you'll hit like the height you need, and because you jumped right where that pillar is, it'll give you the correct angle to actually slow down and land on this little invisible part. And that's the first part. That's really easy to do. You have plenty of time to do this before Gael gets over here, and you can just cheese him with lightning arrows or really like crystal soul spears, trying to think of what else you could use. Things that make you stationary when you cast them, bows would work. If you can get something that moves you and stay up there at the same time, that would work too. But it's much easier with stationary spells and bows and shit like that. After that happens, you're sort of fucked. He'll go into the second stage of his boss fight, and then you'll have to run from all the way over there, over to here. And if you keep sprinting at full speed, I'd say there's like a 50-50 chance you'll make it here without him being over here already attacking you. If he is attacking you, and you know his patterns, which is unlikely since you're trying to cheese him in the first place, you can just bring him over here and roll over and then run and do it again. It's not hard to do, like, just starting out. If you practice it, you can get it probably first try every time. I only did this a couple times just to cheese him, so I'm not super good at it. And then once you get up here after the second stage, he's pretty much gonna always teleport to you from what I've seen. I don't think I've ever seen him stay down there. And I believe that's because you're in an area that his path can't run to, I believe. Like in the first stage of the fight, you'll see him go over, like if you go over to a dune or something, like I don't have bows on me, I have binoculars. So if you go over to, like, say, that dune right there, that wall is in the middle of my screen, and you stand right there, and he's below, like, right there, he'll just keep running into you from the dune for a while until you do enough damage or attack him a certain amount of times, and then he'll finally find a path away. But if his AI doesn't find a path, which is how I think it works, he just teleports straight to you. And, when he teleports to you, his model is too big to get out of this area if he falls into it, and that's why he gets stuck there. And then if you keep attacking him, like since his AI can find a path to you, his AI can go off of ledges, I believe, but it's finding a path to you, so he's not teleporting. So you're good on that front, and then you just stay here, and then this little thing right here blocks all of his crossbow bolts. I believe it blocks all of the ones that he gets from going up in the air and shooting at you too. And then you just cheese him the same way you did up there, except you're standing here. The Dark Souls can still hit you. The Lightning can still hit you, but those are really easy to dodge and will, like, pretty much never kill you in one hit, unless you're complete glass cannon. and you don't have tears, or you get hit twice in a row really fast. It's not that difficult. It's more difficult than the cheese where you kill them with toxic mist, though. Just go over here and toxic mist the fuck out of them, or something, snap freeze, I don't know. There's a video on it. I'll put it in the description. That's really it. I used lightning spheres on the glass cannon build to cheese him last time I did it. But it'd probably be better to use crystal soul spheres on a pure mage build, glass cannon, or maybe great soul dregs. I don't know how those are, but pretty sure they do a lot of damage. I can't think of any pyromancies that would do it very well, because a lot of the pyromancies require that you take a step forward, and that's not a good thing to do. If you're up here and you take a step forward, you're probably gonna fall off. Pretty sure. I don't think I could cast a sunlight spear up here. But I didn't try, because I just assumed I'd fall off. Yeah, so you're sort of fucked. But that's how you do it. Thanks for watching.